What is up, guys? Mario here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to give you guys a quick update on what has been happening with the Z. So the Z has been down about 3 weeks now, almost a month. So I'm going to tell you guys what has been going on with that. We're working off the ground because there's another car on the lift. So we got to do it the old fashioned way. This is how it all started. We're working on the ground. Nothing new. But basically what happened was, inside the transmission there is a pivot ball behind the fork, behind the clutch fork, and as you can see, that pivot ball broke. It's completely broken, and the threading was left inside the housing of the transmission. So we had to take all of this apart, the clutch fork, the throttle bearing, and all that stuff. Take those apart, tap into the old screw that was in there, because as I said, it broke off in there. So we had to tap into that and drill it out and put the new one in. So basically, this pivot ball right here, it sits inside of right here, and you can see the groove right here. That's where it goes in. So that causes the clutch fork to work. How that works is when you engage the clutch. Oh shit, I kind of just popped it out. But basically, when you engage the clutch fork is supposed to push the throttle bearing in and out. So I'm gonna try to get this fixed again because I just accidentally popped it out. But yeah, that's basically what has been happening. So since we had to take the transmission out to fix the pivot ball, I'm just gonna replace the whole clutch and flywheel assembly. So basically I had to get a new clutch and a flywheel, which is right here. I'm gonna show you guys. So the box is right here. Got the tool to put the clutch in, got a brand new flywheel and brand new pressure plate and clutch. So here, guys, brand new flywheel, brand new pressure plates, and a brand new clutch. All right, there we go. So yeah, you can see the brand new clutch. It have a lot of grooves in it still. Let me show you the older clutch that I just took out. As you can see, all the groove is no longer there. It's actually smooth. So this clutch was definitely on its last leg. If I didn't change it, I would definitely have to take the transmission out again and do the whole thing over. So since the pivot ball broke, it's only right that we changed the clutch. So yeah, that's what has been going on. We're going to finish putting this thing that I just messed up, the clutch fork, back together, and put in a new clutch, flywheel, and it should be all set. Also, if you guys are wondering what we used to get it out, we drilled it out with a reverse drill bit. You can see the stud on it still. The stud is supposed to be right there, like that, on the end of that, but it broke off. So yeah, that's how you get it out. And if you're a VQ guy, you have any VQ cars, manual transmission, this is highly likely that it might happen to you. So take precaution, and yeah, that's pretty much what I have to say about that. All right, guys, so it's the next day. Let me show you guys what we have done to the car so far.
All right, guys, so far we got the transmission in. As you can see, and up top we got the shifter linkage is in, shifter bracket is in, transmission is in, as I said before. Now I just gotta mount up the transmission mount and the other mount that's holding the exhaust in place. Slave cylinder is already in, new clutch is in. Yeah, so basically everything is in that needs to be in. I just gotta mount up the transmission mount. So let's put the transmission mount in and put the drive shaft in. So yeah, let's get it.
All right, guys, so another update for y'all. I just got finished putting everything together. Me and the man himself,
And yeah, we got the transmission together, put in the slave, put in the drive shaft, everything that's necessary for it to start driving back perfect. We bled the clutch, which was a hassle. So yeah, we got all of those done. We're gonna take the car for a test drive, see how it reacts, and hopefully all goes well.
So the car is back on the ground. Shift through all the gears perfectly. So we're gonna take it for a test drive and see how it actually performs on the road. So yeah, that's what we're about to do right now.
Ooh, I miss driving this. Yeah, the shit scraped now.
Fifth gear, third gear. Oh, shit. Yup, no bueno.
Yeah. Know what I mean?
What I mean?
Fifth gear, same car, no one.
Shit.
If it's the same time I'm putting a gear.
Yeah.
Yeah. Alright, see the clutch.
See if it. I try going there fast.
Something.
Nah.
Yeah, when the thing is being fucked up, boy.
Guys, it's day three and the Z's finally finished. Last night we had some hiccups, we were hearing some noises from the engine bay, and today we came back, we checked underneath to see what's going on. It turns out that it was just a loose bolt. One of the bolts fell out for the exhaust and it was rattling, so it sounded crazy, but we got it fixed now and it's good to go. The only problem we're hearing right now is the throat bearing. But that's not really major because it's not as loud. So apart from that, the Z is finally finished and it's good to hit the road now. So everything is good with the Z now. Just need to give it a nice wash and she's back on the road. Look at that angle right there. That's perfect. But I'm about to wrap up this video right here. I hope you guys liked it. It's basically an update on what has been happening with the Z. And now it's drivable. I can enjoy the car. New clutch. New throwout bearing. New flywheel. And a new pivot ball. So, yeah. All of those are installed. The Z's driving good. So, win-win. With that being said, leave a like, drop a comment, and make sure you hit that subscribe button. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Peace.